Good Monday morning from the International Space Station Flight Control Room. This is Mission Control Houston. You're looking at a team of flight controllers that have been working on console since early this morning, watching over all systems aboard the International Space Station. The team is on a 9-hour rotation shift, covering three shifts around the clock to support International Space Station operations. The team today is being led by veteran flight director Emily Nelson. She is overseeing this team throughout the day. She's also joined on her right by Christy Bertels, who is serving as the communications link between the flight control team here and the crew aboard the International Space Station. The International Space Station is currently flying high above Europe, currently passing across Turkey on a southeasterly trajectory that will take it into an orbital sunset here in about 10 minutes or so. And from this vantage point of 247 statute miles, the station is circling the Earth every 92 minutes. And that, of course, means the station's traveling about 5 miles per second, or about 17,000 miles per hour. On board the station now, a new crew, Expedition 32. Of course, these three gentlemen have been aboard the station for 50 days in space, but they have transitioned to Expedition 32. In the center is the commander of Expedition 32, Gennady Padalka. On his left is U.S. astronaut Joe Acaba. On his right is Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin. These three crew members transitioned to Expedition 32 late Saturday night, U.S. Central Time, after the departure of three other crew members that made up Expedition 31. Oleg Kononenko, Andrei Kuipers, and Don Pettit returned home early Sunday morning after 193 days in space, 191 days aboard the International Space Station. They returned home to partly cloudy skies, beautiful video of the return home of their Soyuz TMA-03M spacecraft on the steppe of Kazakhstan, just to the southeast of Jezkazgan, which is in the southern landing zone targeted for that return home. Those three crew members now safely back with Gennady or Oleg Kononenko back in Star City, just outside Moscow, and Kuipers and Pettit returned home aboard a NASA plane shortly after checkups and the landing, and they are now back here in Houston. The crew on board today spending some off-duty time, but they also are continuing to work on experiments and housekeeping chores around the International Space Station. Padalka and Revin have been inspecting some circuit breakers and some fuses in the pier's docking compartment of the Russian segment. They've also performed some maintenance in the Zvezda service module's ventilation system and some Earth observation photography as well. Acaba is been working with the flight control team here in Houston on some several experiments that are overseen by NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama. He's also performed a communications test between the onboard smartphone that is aboard the station that's associated with the SPHERES experiment, known as the Synchronized Position Hold Engage Reorient experimental satellites, those small bowling ball sized satellites that are used for interaction with school kids on the ground through some autonomous robotic operations. So the crew members will wrap up their day as usual with going to bed about 4:30 in the afternoon, but they continue throughout the latter half of their day working with the station systems and ensuring that all of the components aboard the station are in good working order, supporting their activities on board as they press through what's now their 50th day in space, their 48th day aboard the International Space Station.